I am so excited to welcome tonight's musical guest. It is such a perfect pairing for our climate change exhibit. Not only is Sarah an award-winning singer-songwriter, but she also has a background in microbiology. She's an avid gardener and a bluebird monitor at Kenyon College. Is that right? There you go. She has over 11 CDs that she has put out over many, many years. The latest, The Healing, was released in 2022. Now, on a personal note, Sarah and I have known each other for about 12 years, and she and I worked together from 2012 to 16 alongside Lisa Biales, where is she in the back over there, on the Ohio Arts Professionals Network Board. So we spent a lot of board meetings together and board retreats and working through all the kind of things that we do for the state of Ohio. This is the third time as an arts presenter that I have had the privilege of booking Sarah to wow an audience with her music. And so it is not just the third time, but every time is the charm. Please give a warm Oxford welcome to my very good friend, Sarah Goslee Reed.
Well, thank you, Heidi. That was a wonderful introduction. I should have recorded that so that I can remember in case somebody wants to introduce me another time. I'll go, oh, just use this. That was cool. Whoa. That is bright. Well, I'm so excited to be back in Oxford, where I, many years ago, frequented for about 4 years, because I went to college here. And this was a dorm when I was here, but I did not live here. But I spent a lot of time hanging out uptown at Beasley's Bakery. Anybody been there? Is that still, does it still exist? Oh, man, you know, the Tuffies, oh, well, okay. Here we are, gotta get used to it. Climate change, Oxford change, right? So here we go. This old place is for a room. There's furniture everywhere. Six beds are empty most of the time. Got three couches to spare. When you're gone, it's too much house. Even the walls are quiet. Floors creak and echo, but when you all can't deny it. It's cold in the winter, but we never tire when you come to stay. We crank thermostats and build a fire. It's a family holiday. Front and back stairs, and the two of us are always looking for one another. I go up the back ones while he goes down the other. Dogs bark, kids squeal, doors fly open, the kitchen table is covered. Crafts and toys, food and noise, with hugs and kisses we're smothered. It's warm in the summer, but we've got trees. When you come to open the windows and feel the breeze. It's a family holiday. Mm-hmm. and be gone. But when you return, the party lights will come on. It's cold in the winter, but we never tire when you come to stay. We crank thermostats and build a fire. It's a family holiday. It's warm in the summer, but we've got trees when you come to stay. We open the windows and feel the breeze. It's a family holiday. It's a family holiday. Thank you. That's called Family Holiday, in case you couldn't guess that. And that pretty much describes our life these days in our little house in Mount Vernon, my husband and I, with the two stairways that go up and down, and we're always, where are you? Where are you? It's very fun, especially since he's retired. He's there all the time. Where is he? There he is. It's okay. I like him. He's allowed to be there all the time. So I have not had a chance to look at all the artwork out there, so I hope when we're done I can like zip around and see everything. But this next song is... It's called One Square Inch of Silence, and there is a man named Gordon Hempton who travels around the country looking for quiet places, kind of like the dark skies, you know, where you can go way out and see the stars and not see the cities. So he goes out and looks for places that are quiet, and you can't hear airplanes or anything except nature. And this place, One Square Inch of Silence, actually exists in the Ho Rainforest in the state of Washington, where it is a mossy, spongy, earthy, oh, it is so gorgeous. And it's so, you just walk through and it's like the best carpet you ever bought. But you didn't buy it because it's out there, and it's just, oh, it's lovely. So this is a song about quiet. And then we'll, you know, we'll just all sit here and be quiet for a while. Furnace clicks, airplane thrums. Overhead fluorescent light bulbs hum. Mow the lawn, blow the leaves. Squeaky wheels need some grease. Dog barks, baby cries. Fridge and washer chime in their reply. Swish, buzz, ding, computer, phone. To be alone in one square inch of silence. The smell of earth is on the breeze, where the still and quiet covers me. A green and mossy blanket on the trees. One square inch. In a jar, make a wish for room. Thank you. Yes, I'd like to introduce my good friend Tom Martin on bass this evening. Yay! Make lots of noise so more people come in. Yeah, that's good. And now he's going to play the piano. If we keep really quiet, he will not get out his kazoo, right?
I'm not promising anything.
Don't give him a microphone.
Take that away.
Tom and I have done shows for many years for first graders in Knox County, where I live. 700 first graders come into the Memorial Theater, which has a ballroom that looks a lot like this, but the theater holds about almost 1,000 people. So you have 700 first graders in there, and it's a lot of fun. And occasionally we allow him to talk.
Not too long.
So the next three songs that I'm going to do are songs of healing, songs healing the earth, healing us as people, healing all of us together, the earth and people. I will let you take these songs, I will let you put them in your heart, and you can see what you think they mean. This one is called The Healing.
Feels like it's February, so long ago. I could swear I hear the very voice I used to know. The ritual I go through year after year. The only thing I know to do. With a shovel in my hand, without a sound, opening the earth, I plant a seed in this hallowed ground. Dust turned to mud, cold winter rain. I don't know. Will never end.
you. Okay, so now here's my big solo.
On my own.
You can have a break. So that song is the title song from my CD from 2022, which seems like just the other day. And the CD is called The Healing, and there are some back there, as well as other CDs. And this song is one that I grew to love over 50 years ago, oh good grief, when I was here as a student, and I first heard it, and I would sing along with it, and I loved it, and I knew the words, and I never could quite figure out where the harmony was and where the melody was and how to play it. And it has taken me this long, I'm a slow learner apparently, to figure it out.
Window like a moth. just a box of rain. I don't know who put it there. Believe it if you need it. Believe it if you dare. And it's just a box of rain or a ribbon for your hair. Such a long, long time to be gone and a short time to be there.
So that is a song by Robert Hunter, in case you were wondering and didn't recognize that old Grateful Dead song. Most of the songs that I'm doing tonight are ones I've written. That one obviously was not. This one is, and this is the a song for all of us to remember to take care of each other.
Hide, fill the hole in our hearts deep inside.
you. So here we are, it's 2024, and I'm sure a lot of you remember the turn of the century, the Y2K, and all of those crazy things that happened back in 1999 and the year 2000. And we thought, first of all, the world might end. Thankfully, it did not. And this song is called Turn of the Century. And so I was thinking, wow, here we are. We're a quarter of the way almost through this century now. That is really a scary thought. So anyway, when I learned this back in the 90s, oh, wow, that's how it's going to be. And it's not, we're not there yet. So we'll give it a little more time.
There'll be singing about that sweet old by and by. Hallelujah. I can't wait to see it. Hallelujah. Come on and go with me. I want to show you just how great life's gonna be. to show
you. Well, at this point in the program, I have a friend from the audience who I would like to invite up. Her name is Lisa. Giggle. Lisa Biales.
Thanks, Sarah.
Yeah, and there we have many ties here between us, among us. There's three of us. That's right. So Lisa is the person who many years ago introduced me to Tom. That's one connection.
Yeah.
Another connection is that Lisa and I played then after I met Tom, and I just sort of knew Lisa. We began a correspondence by letter.
That's right.
I lived in Mount Vernon, and Lisa lived in
Athens.
And for a while, Tom lived in Athens. And we moved all around between those places. But Lisa and I wrote letters to each other and talked about what songs we might like to learn and you know, that kind of stuff. It was super fun. I mean, who writes letters, you know? Well, that was before email.
That's right.
I think.
It was before
cell. I know it was before cell phones. Yeah. Heavens. So we have that connection, and Lisa and I played and sang together for many years. Over 20, a long time. We traveled a lot around Ohio, up into Michigan, into West Virginia, and occasionally we went other places.
New York.
That was fun. When we did a lot of schools and libraries and kids shows, and I think we did one here for children many moons ago, and she was in on those first with those first graders too. You know, that was a lot of fun. So we're going to do a couple of songs, and I'm so excited. This is our reunion tour of One Night. Are you ready?
Okay.
Ready? Here we go.
Once loved a sailor, once a sailor loved me. He was not a sailor who sailed on the wide rolling sea. He sailed in an airship, free as a bird on the wing, and every Sunday evening, he'd fly past my window and sing, "Oh, come take a trip in my airship. Come let us sail to the stars. Come let us fly off to Venus. Come take a trip around Mars. No one will know when we're kissing. No one will see when we spoon. Come take a trip in my airship, and we'll visit the man in the moon."
One night while sailing away from the crowds, I gave him my heart. The sun shines on our honeymoon. We swore to each other we never would part, and we teach all our babies this tune.
Oh, come take a trip in my airship. Come let us sail to the stars. Come let
that is a song that was written, I believe, back in the early 1900s, at the other, another turn of the century, when people were trying to escape, maybe a little. So maybe we should all try that. But it has to be a Sunday night, and you have to be able to grab that airship as it flies by your window. I think it's kind of like Peter Pan myself. This next song is one, I almost remember who wrote that song. George Evans and Wren Shield.
Wow, that's good.
You know what? I don't know what I had for breakfast, but I can come up with that. This next song is called Cowboy on the Highway. And it's one that Lisa and I have done for, did many years ago and did a lot. As I was practicing it, it occurred to me that some of these lyrics in these songs are not so much about people, but could be about the earth and what's going on. So as you listen, maybe don't think of a person, think about the earth and what's happening here. So. Stories of the buffalo. She took them there to see them. Now they are no more. Ooh. She saw them in the corner of her eye. She saw him too, then he drifted off. Thank you.
she went the way of the buffalo.
This is really fun, in case you couldn't tell. Okay, you can, you're awfully quiet. Okay, what are we doing? Find
the right spot here. The magic spot.
This is a song called Love is Like Sand. Love is like time,
carving through the hourglass,
passing you by when it's your turn to play.
Love is like sand,
slipping through your fingers. To walk in step with each other, we used to talk so the other could hear. Now we're walking in two different strides, and the distance is so deep and wide, feels like one of us might disappear. We used to laugh,
we used to poke. Never seeming to care.
Now we're pointing fingers, causing pain. Can we learn to smile again? Do we still have something to share? Love is like time,
pouring through the hourglass,
passing you by when it's your turn to play. Drifting apart, have storm winds blown us out of reach, washed away the sand under our feet,
left us howling in the dark.
Love is like time,
pouring through the hourglass,
passing you by
when it's your turn to play.
It slips away.
Yay.
Oh, Lisa, big round of applause. Thank you. I'm going to be smiling about this all night long. So we had, we had a little song about the airship and, you know, out in space, and we have. We're moving into the astronomy portion of the show, sort of. This song is called Ring Around the Moon. So bright.